Hello Tushar, welcome to Bollywood World, and how's everything going?
Good, yeah. It's going all right. Now I think the phase of hopefully lockdown getting over. I mean, it's not over, but mentally thoda sa we've gone into that phase. So yeah, I'm hoping it'll be better.
So I mean, are you feeling anxious as the unlock is progressing?
I mean, I'm slightly anxious because, you know, the cases are not coming down. So anxious, yes, because I really feel, you know, everyone is in that space that we've been home for 5-6 months now. And there's this inherent need to just go out and start working and, you know, start saying yes to work. And and at the same time, one is aware of the state is really going in a bad space because the cases are going up.
It is.
And so, yeah, it's that tussle because I think Abhina Bola Stithi aa gaya, somewhere I read ki jo hoga dekha jayega kind of mentality. But I don't know. I'm still figuring it out how to best to go about it.
Okay. So, talking about Ashram, you know, it's garnering rave reviews from all around the corners, be it critics or the audience. So, yeah. I mean, when you started up with this project, did you like expected it to become, you know, go it so big in terms of approach and
I had no idea how audience will take it because I had read the text. I was aware of the depth of the script. And, you know, I think you must have spoken to so many other actors from the series that everybody was so excited to work with Mr. Prakashra, sir. And that grandeur of his world, and grandeur, I mean, you know, the reality at which he shoots. I mean, he actually takes you to that place, that feeling. And he rarely shoots on sets. So I think that when I was, so that was the biggest draw and excitement for me to be able to work with him. But the script had so much layers, specifically when you see today's series, OTT platform series, you know, very rarely I come across a series where there are so many parallel stories running and so much happening. Yes, that's the beauty of series, that you have so many characters in depth, but I started realizing that Ashram had so much in it. So I felt there is definitely something grand about the whole setup. And that's what it was. I mean, I never expected. I had no clue how the audience will take it, frankly. No idea.
Okay. And since you mentioned about, you know, working on real locations with Prakashra, now this is a very interesting thing because Christopher Nolan also, he prefers to, you know, to shoot on actual locations and not just, you know, on set or, you know, with VFX or everything. So I want to understand from you what strengths or like how does it add up to your performance or how does it notch up your performance when you perform in a real location instead of a set or you know, in front of a chroma screen.
Yeah, it does so much now because what happens is at the end of the day, performance is so much about imagination. You know, as an actor, when we act on stage, when we act on places, we have to imagine so much about the character, their background, their relationship. Sometimes we don't even have a co-actor who we're looking at. We're looking at an AD who's just reading a flat line and we're emoting. There's so much an actor has to imagine to perform that sometimes that when you go to a real location, now you get so many inspirations. You know, for example, since you've seen the series, there are portions when we're shooting at a house, Lochan Parivar house. We actually went to a very small village and we were in their room, which is actually just one, no, I can't say one bedroom. It was just Itos bana hua, you know, ghar tha. Aur wahan baith ke jo aap aisa nahi tha ki ek sofa ko ya ek acche se bed pe aapne chadar dal diye to give an impression ki ye gareeb ya ye, no, ye used poor. No, it was actually their place where you sleep and just to be with them, interact with them, you know, there are small nuances that you start getting. And I think real location does that to you, that it kind of helps you more. Thodi imagination kam karke na reality zyada check ho jati hai. And I think that's the beauty why Prakashra sir is so brilliant, that he gives you that without you expecting it. So, I mean, I actually loved it. You know, I lived in an urban setup. I mean, I've lived in a metros. I have lived abroad a few years of my life. To be able to go to heart of India, to be able to see firsthand how people live, how people experience. I mean, this is a rare experience that as an actor, I would want to get it. And I think that's what it is. I mean, it definitely adds.
Okay. And I was speaking to your co-actor, Chandan, a few hours back. And interestingly, both you and him started off with Rang De Basanti. He played the part of Haltukeshwar Das in Rang De Basanti, which eventually got edited out. And yours was something that, you know, people still remember. And it's so popular for bringing in the comic element. So, I mean, while you were shooting for this, or you know, while you were together working on Ashram, did you get a chance to reminisce those days of Rang De Basanti or some anecdotes that you shared with me?
I mean, we shared a really good bond off screen, off camera. Mm-hmm. And we, I mean, that's the beauty of it, that we enjoyed the process so much more because we were there for like 4 or 5 months, all the actors, most of them. And even though we didn't had tracks with few of the others, we would always hang out after shoot in the hotel because wahan kuch aur karne ko hi nahi tha. Highway mein ek hotel tha jiske kuch bhi nahi hai. So the only thing you could rely on is your co-actor, and luckily it was such a good bond. So yeah, I mean, if I talk of Rang De Basanti, no, we never interacted directly about it, but you know, there are small anecdotes he would share, and I would tell him mine, because I never was supposed to act in it. I was studying in a college. I happened to be on the set that day because Delhi mein jagah India Habitat Center. So they were shooting this one portion. I just went to see the shoot with two of my friends, and hum college mein tumne shoot dekh ke aate hain, and we happened to be one of the ADs who just said, you know, ye line bol do. Yaar, it's a line bol de. Hum actor to the hi college mein, you know, used to do plays. So we said that dialogues, and we never realized we got 1500 rupees. So for us, it was like, ye to yaar party ka din hai. Matlab, we just went to see the shoot. Upar se 1500 rupees mil gaye 15 saal pehle. So, I mean, for me, it was just a thing to just be able to do it. And I'm so surprised even now people talk about randomly, you know, I saw in Rang De Basanti that, yeah, it's a good thing. It's just a fun laughter experience.
So, going back to your college days, you know, you have been an alumnus of Kirodimal College. So, ye jo acting ka jo chaska hai, ye wahin se start hua tha, and were you a part of The Players, which is the Dramatic Society of...
Yes. I've been a student in school, jahan pe na har kuch mein participate karta tha. Jack of all trades. You know, you asked me to do music, you asked me to play football, cricket, everything. I've done every part competition, school ki taraf se, inter school. So, you know, those kids who just want to do every extracurricular activity. It's only when I got into college, and in Delhi, na, like you have sports admission in colleges, you also have theatre admissions in Delhi University. So, I got through Kirodimal College through theatre admission. So, I was in players admission in the college. So, I had to do 3 years of players. I directed, I acted in so many plays, and I think that's what gave me the understanding of seriousness of work in theatre, because player really works very clearly and very wholeheartedly. So, uski wajah se, I got a sense of actually that there is an interest in me, and I applied to National School of Drama, and then things further moved on. But yes, players was the reason why I am still doing what I'm doing.
Okay. And you know, since you yourself mentioned that you have been a lot of activities, and you are more into co-curricular activities, and also you have directed plays while, you know, being a part of the Dramatic Society. So, how does this experience of, you know, being the jack of all trades, or, you know, venturing into different zones of the student life or the artistic life, how does it help you as an actor, and how does it help you to grow?
It does, because, you know, I'm a trained actor, because I've actually trained 8 years of my life professionally learning acting. So what I've really realized is, at the end of the day, what you got to do is you have to try get the rhythm of a character, because har bande ka ek rhythm, ek personality alag hota hai, because of which the way you react to situations, the way you react to things, people, everything affects you differently. So based down, deep down, how I approach it, I try and find the rhythm of the actor. And now rhythm can be understood in many different ways. I will not dive into that too much. But so the idea is, when you yourself are ready to try 20 things in your life, now you like, for example, I have played in a team sport like football. I have also done badminton and things, if I talk of sports. I have done things like painting, which I'm not very good at. I've actually learned an instrument. What happens is, suddenly your brain starts working in 20 different ways when you're working in 20 different things. Even now, I try and do different kind of workshops just for me to keep engaging myself in different things. And as an actor, that's what you want to do, because you never want to end up with a similar approach to a character. You know, like in Ashram, I played a guy who is very in a back foot. He would not somebody who will charge up to things. You know, he would not somebody who will engage in a fight. Now, that needs a very different mental attitude to life, to kind of consume yourself with whatever has happening to you. And that needs a different mindset to enter. And I think somehow that's what my experiences have done. They've given me an approach to say, okay, let me try this. How does this work? Some things I'm not good at, I usually take a back step and say, okay, let me just figure it out how to do it. Sometimes I'm the one who's jumping in front of everyone. So I think as an actor, I really feel to just exposing yourself to many other facets in life helps you deep down somewhere. And as an actor, that's what my aim always is.
Okay. And, you know, since you spoke about, you know, analyzing yourself, you know, by stepping into the shoes of a character, there's also an aspect of being a person, being, you know, being Tushar. You also analyze your performance or how you are approaching the character. So I want to understand, at that moment, does the Brecht's alienation effect come into place? I mean, do you break the fourth wall with yourself as a person and as an actor?
Where is the audience? You're also aware that aapke jo spotlight pad rahi hai na, वो कितना आपने कदम पीछे ले लिया तो लाइट से बाहर हो जाओगे. सो व्हाट यू आर ऑलवेज डूइंग इज यू आर ऑलवेज लुकिंग एट योरसेल्फ फ्रॉम आउटसाइड एनीवेज व्हेन यू परफॉर्म. यू नो समहाउ फिल्म गिव्स यू दैट लिबर्टी समटाइम्स टू स्विच दैट आउटसाइड पर्सपेक्टिव ऑफ बिकॉज यू नो कट हो जाएगा. अगर आप फ्रेम से बाहर चले गए तो कट हो जाएगा. स्टेज में यू डोंट हैव एन ऑप्शन. सो सडनली यू ऑलवेज आर अवेयर ऑफ योरसेल्फ विद इन यू एंड यू आर ऑल्सो अवेयर ऑफ हाउ यू बीइंग परसीव फ्रॉम आउटसाइड. That changes with different performances. When you do a street play, it's a very different approach to performing. And when you do, let's say, a very immersive theater where an audience is sitting right next to you while you're performing, changes. So you're always, again, as I'm saying, you're always putting yourself in different shoes, not just as an actor, but also as a perspective view. So not Brecht then goes into a different chapter altogether. But yes, if I answer you to say, do I always try and keep an eye on myself? Yes, because that's how my training has been. But it changes sometimes. Like in ashram, like in on screen, I don't always have to think, ki acha, you know, ye bahar zyada to nahi ho gaya, because I know there are people who are actually looking at the monitor and deciding. Yeah. So you figure.
Okay. And then you, after Kironimal, you went on to, you know, get admission in NSD. What was the year that you graduated from there, from NSD?
2009. It's been 11 years.
Okay. So, I mean, I guess Anuradha Kapoor ma'am must be your director.
Yeah. So, she when I was in the first year, Dr. Ankur was the director. And then I think in the second year, Anuradha ma'am took over. So, for last two, second, third year, Anuradha ma'am was.
Okay. So, you know, she's known for bringing, you know, a very open culture into the institute with amongst all stakeholders, be in terms of, you know, students, faculty, administration. And it's about, you know, like a dialogue or a grievance readdressal, the kind of open culture I'm talking about. So I want to understand from you that what were some of the most important learning that you acquired from her as your guru?
Well, you know, I mean, I think for me personally, she has been a very important teacher because she has been somebody who kind of also guided me, because I was very clear by the time I finished my second year that what I want to do after NSD. So I realized that by the time I'm in second year that, you know, 3 years of NSD training is not enough for me as an actor. I want to train further. And she would be the one I would always, even though she was a director, I would knock her door regularly and say, you know, I'm thinking of this school. What do you think? And she actually guided me a lot, because after NSD, I moved to London to train further in acting. And I mean, I felt that relationship with her was that I could go ask her. You know, I will remember after even performing as a student in my second year plays, I would go to her room sometimes if I'm in a break and say, what do you think of my performance? You know, and it's difficult because very rarely you have, in at least our culture, I mean, it's not very easy for you to barge into a teacher's room and say, you know, what do you think? What, how? And I think she gave that sense of liberty that I really felt relaxed to be able to ask her, question her. And in fact, I co-directed with her a play after I came back from London for an SD third years. So, I mean, for me, she has been a very important arc, because from being my teacher, I taught with her in National School Drama, to co-directing with her. So, I mean, yes, that open space, I think mental open space is what she has definitely given, both as students and as a school. to National School of Drama to go further in where all of us have been.
And Chichore recently completed a year. So while it's a moment of joy, I mean, there's also a sense of sadness because one of the team members is no longer with us to celebrate the success. Sushant ko leke jo mahol chal raha hai uske baare mein to main nahi puchunga. But I would want you to share some special memories that the two of you had while working on Chichore, or jiske through Sushant will be a part of your life till eternity.
I mean, he will be, for me, Chichore has been a very big film, personally, a very important film, both in terms of the exposure that film gave me, also the kind of appreciation it's the first that bigger film that I got appreciation for, to be a part of it. So for me, that film holds a very important place. And on top of that, when I happened to spend such an important time of my life, of my journey with Sushant and all the other members, it suddenly becomes a very important part of me. And I've said quite a few times is, some people have really inspired me when I'm on set, because what happens is everybody has a position. Sushant had been somebody who had risen to such big, high positions that when we interacted, I never got a feeling that, there is a sense of that he's achieved so much and I am fairly new to the industry, even though in terms of our training, we have both trained. But he would be so open for rehearsal. He would be so open for suggestions. I remember there were a couple of scenes where, he would ask me, what do you think? Because he knew about my theater background. And he was somebody who was interested in theater a lot. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, I really felt genuinely elevated in terms of being exposed to such brilliant minds and people. Mm-hmm. And things. Mm-hmm. So I think he is an inspiration. And I'm glad I was able to be a part of that film, and he was able to be a part of my life now forever.
And you have worked with some of the wonderful artists of Hindi cinema, Mr. Bachchan, Sushant, Tapsi, even for that matter, Shraddha, and of course Prakash with this one. So what's that common thread between all of us that connects them? Like, what's a common trait that defines each of them?
I think, that sense of always feeling fresh, always feeling that this is, that they haven't done it forever and they know it. There's always a sense of discovery, always a sense of saying, let me figure out of what new I will find. I think same with Sushant and even Mr. Bachchan. I remember, so there's a scene in the film that got edited finally in Pink. And there was this courtroom scene where I was in the category and Mr. Bachchan would ask me questions. And he would really corner me because I was that guy who was kind of, was both-sided, He was also supporting me. And I remember I got this 2-page scene very last minute, and I was like, okay, I came from a dunya of rehearsals, so mera tha yaar rehearsal karne ko mil jati, but obviously Mr. Bachchan. So I remember I was just going through the lines a couple of times, and I heard Tushar, rehearsal karne. So I started rehearsing, and every time I finished the scene, mujhe laga abhi kahenge acha ho gaya. And he said, ek aur baar kar le kya? And I'm not kidding. I'm genuinely saying we must have rehearsed like 8, 9, 10 times that scene. And for me, I started enjoying it so much because I come from a dunya ki yaar rehearsal jitni karo utna acha hai. And to be able to get to that kind of experience with these people, same with Sushant, I remember this one scene where both of us are walking from the girls' hostel with kapde. And he was like, "Theko kya lagta hai? Main aise kuch try karun." And, that was not a difficult scene to act. I mean, I'm very sure he would have done it in the one thought he had. But he was like, "Nahi yaar, kuch naya karte na. Let me try this. Tere mein se pange le le kuch." And I always felt, that's the beauty of actors, that they are always ready to try something new. And I've, all the names you've taken, I think, for all of them, that thing, that this, they feel it's their first film. They approach it like a first film. And Mr. Bachchan, to, if I talk of there, his commitment to work is like no one. I mean, something to learn every time he's on set. First one to almost come on set, he would be there reading his script all the time. No, obviously he would have done it in few takes if he want. But he would give like first take as his best take, and then he would say, "Ek aur karte hain."
So, the more you rehearse, the quotient of spontaneity, it comes down. It starts reducing because you are well acquainted with your surroundings on the set and every tangible thing that's there on the set. So how do you deal with that, and how do you amp up your spontaneity even after, you know, repeated rounds of rehearsals?
Well, yeah, it's a good question. I'll tell you how it's not true. What happens is when you are rehearsing a lot now, what you're doing is you're basically memorizing things that are essential to the scene. But then what happens, it gives you a scope of trying new things. Because otherwise, you know, you'll be stuck with lines, you'll be stuck with basic blocking. Agar aap bahut rehearsal nahi karenge. Agar aap achhi time pe rehearsal kar lenge na, you can get a sense of what's happening is your tumhare basic pillars sab sorted hai. And then what happens is when you're performing, you start listening to the actor. Once you start listening to the actor, na, your way of response changes. So sometimes what happens, if I have to say a line, I have been here. Now, I will rehearse with you and say, I have been here. What I've done, I've taken almost equal pauses on the four words.
Yeah.
Ab rehearsal ka matlab ye nahi hota ki main shoot, matlab take bhi dunga, to main I have been here hi bolunga. It might change, I have been here. It might do this, but what really happens is I've kind of given myself that sense ki itna to maine bhar liya hai. Ab jo mujhe bharna ya khelna hai na, that will happen that very moment because I'm not bothered with basic jo cheez karni hai. So I really feel what rehearsal does is it eliminates this monotony. And then you start discovering something. So I personally believe it's a wrong notion that rehearsal takes away the improvisational quality.
And taking this work, as an actor, you do your homework before going on set.
Very much.
And then the director comes and he himself or herself adds their input. And that's how a character is brought to life on screen. But there are certain directors who don't like their actors to come prepared on set. For example, if I have to quote Anurag Kashyap, you know, he's someone who would tear down your papers if you go by the book and completely prepared, because he's someone who derives his energy from chaos and, you know, from the spontaneity and everything that's going bizarre on the set. So while working on Ashram, which of the two methods did you come across while working with Prakash?
I tell you what, I personally believe actor should be prepared. Director doesn't need to know I prepared. There is no rule to say ki main aaunga aur main char box tick kar dunga, matlab tabhi main prepared. So as an actor, I need to know basic things. See, otherwise every time I perform, I will be in the rhythm of Tushar. Because when I speak fast in my natural life. Yeah, I have a reflexes a little quicker. So when I'm speaking, you would probably see that I'm moving a little faster. I will speak a little faster. Now, if I'm not prepared, thinking about the background, the history, the thought process, the psyche of an actor, every time if I'm just doing it, I'm going to do it the way Tushar would react. So for me, the preparation is important to go into the understanding of what my character's dunya is. Now, yes, a director can say, you know what, I don't want you to go through lines. I just want you to react to what's happening in the situation. But obviously, I'll have to react it within the character. Na? Manoj Vajpayee, sorry, playing Gangs of Wasseypur, he was that character. Yeah? He wasn't Manoj Vajpayee you would have seen in hundreds of the pro. Because he knows the psyche of the character, and then probably he would have done so many things as Anurag Kashyap would have asked him to do, and he would have reacted. I think director doesn't need to know I have prepared or not. It's my job to get prepared. Like, as I'm sure Mr. Anurag Kashyap would have rehearsed his shots in his head. He would have known where I want to shoot.
There's a broad outline.
Yeah, he will not say, "Acha, main camera leke chalta hu aaj, jahan bhi man karega shoot karwa." Kuch to thought kara hoga. Utna kaam to as an actor mujhe bhi karna padega. Jo lighting wale ne bhi kiya hoga na. DOP in to nahi bolega, main light nahi leke jaunga. Dekhte hain. Ho nahi sakta. So I think hum log na zyada soch lete hain ki actor ka kaam na preparation ka hota nahi hai. He's not a professional. I'm generally saying that anyone can act. I really feel you have to be trained enough to act. Now, training doesn't mean going to a school. But working on yourself is essential, because then everything is same. So I will disagree.
Okay. And you also mentioned about, you know, how an actor learns from his co-actor while delivering the lines. It's all about, you know, acting and reacting. Breaking this down further, how much a costume helps you while you're in your frame? Because, you know, as a character, there might be the role of, say, a CEO, which wears a crisp shirt, neatly ironed shirt, and then
a role of a CEO
or, you know, or some board director of an organization, which requires you to be, you know, maintain that stature, you know, wearing a neatly creased ironed shirt. And on the other hand, there could be a college student who's very lackluster, laid back. So how much does a costume add to your performance?
I mean, there's a book called Natyashastra, which basically breaks down the whole idea of performance and theater and things like that. And the whole idea of aharya, you know, external things, becomes a very significant part of character. Why? Because at the end of the day, I am my body. Whichever character I play, I am this body.
Yeah.
How I will change it will give a different physical appearance, both to the audience and to myself when I look into the mirror. The very big learning I have is, you know, rasa, which is, says emotion, if I very loosely translate it, it says rasa is for the audience. It's not for the actor.
Yeah.
You have to feel, I am depressed, or in ashram, I am somebody who is fucked in his life, who's lost his life because of Baba. I don't have to always feel that. I have to feel right emotion to play it. So what I'm trying to say is a lot of things help me to emote correctly, but it also helps the audience to experience what I'm going through. So yes, aharya puts me in that completely social position of how my character has to be perceived. Like in ashram, I decided I will not properly shave my beard. So if you see, I have like a couple of hair in my neck here, because I realize I cannot be looking in a model chiseled beard. You know, it has to grow in its own shape. I decided I will never comb my hair except for a couple of scenes. So every time I would go, I would always roughen my hair, because I thought a guy like him would never think of combing his hair. I mean, wo kaam kar raha hai jis kisam ki jagah pe, isme, and he will not think of these things. So definitely wearing the costume, putting your getup adds to the quality of an actor. But yes, tomorrow if you'll say, you know, the kind of, like theater mein jab karte hain, a lot of times we wear a black t-shirt and a black trousers. A neutrality, one is said. But still we end up playing a very rich guy and a very poor guy. The idea is, obviously, I have to deep down believe in what my character is, but this costume helps me portray the image correctly to the audience. So I am, yes, it helps a lot, but it also to give an experience to the audience and more of that, I guess.
And, you know, with everything going currently, with the pandemic and all, and, you know, people behaving in a weird way as of now, and kuch na kuch absurdity hoti rehti hai. कहीं ना कहीं कुछ ना कुछ नया निकल ही आता है एंड द वर्ल्ड इज नॉट एट पीस इफ वी कुड से दैट सेफली सो इस वक्त पे आर्ट ऑफ इग्नोरेंस कितना जरूरी है अपने आप की सैनिटी मेंटेन करने के लिए
यार इट्स अ वेरी कॉम्प्लेक्स क्वेश्चन बिकॉज एट द एंड ऑफ द डे आर्ट कैन नॉट बी अबाउट इग्नोरेंस यू नो आई मीन one
no I mean not, as in being selective about your ignorance in that
yeah I mean what I'm trying to I think I misinterpreted your question also no I think it is important to how much it affects but at the same time you have to be aware of what's happening in the world and I'm personally very confused I don't even know it's I think I'm more responding I don't have a response to it directly because I don't know if you're all figuring out especially with things happening around I have become selective in what I see, how I see, how I respond. But at the same time, I sometimes question myself and say, you know, it's not right because at the end of the day, I'm part of this world and how, where things move ahead will also be how I acknowledge to things, not just for me, but for the social order, because that's how society works. Society works with all of us being responsible and responding to things where I feel it's not right or it's right. I think all of us are in that jostling position to understand where do we fit in, how much do we respond to things, and if we don't respond, it's a moral ethics that we're negating. So I don't know, yaar. I'm genuinely figuring it out. I really don't know how much of that ignorance is important and how much of ignorance is becoming a wrong thing for me ethically. So I don't know. I'm figuring myself. It's a good question. I'll probably want to ask this question to others and see how they respond.
Okay. And lastly, Ashram 2 is also, you know, up for its release in some time, in 3 months. So would you like to give us an update about it?
So the thing is, we shot it because at the end of the season, you already see a trailer. So what's going to come, what's coming. So we've shot it. We're also looking forward to the announcement. I think they should be announcing it very, very soon. But it's a very exciting plot to say it. And I am more amazed because there were a lot of plots I hadn't seen. Because there are a lot of characters whose journey I hadn't seen. And to be able to see that. And so we do a lot of WhatsApp call these days. Our mini ashram cast team. And you know, and there are a lot of actors within us where we are very critical of our work. So we mm-hmm. always respond to each other's performance. So you know, I remember like me, Chandan, Darshan, Bobby sir, Sachin, Vikram. We regularly do these video calls, and initially after the release, when we saw it, we actually started talking about each other's character in depth. And that's been a real blessing and advantage, because I hadn't seen Darshan perform. Darshan hadn't seen any of my performances. Mm-hmm. So to be able to discuss with each other, you know, give feedback, actually positive and negative, has really been a blessing. So all of us are like saying, "Acha, aap tu aane do," you know. So yeah, I mean, we're ourselves looking forward to, because none of us have seen it, anything. I've read the whole season, so I know story-wise what's going to happen. But yeah, it's going to be announced very, very soon. Sorry, I can't say when. Otherwise, it's
all fine. I understand you're bound by a contract and certain
legal. But I think very, very soon they're going to announce it.
Yeah. Cool. So with that, we have reached the end of this conversation. I would like to know if there's something that as a question I may have missed out asking and you would have loved to
answer. No, nothing. I think the great thing is, I mean, some conversations are interesting because it's not about these generic questions, you know. It's also a thing where you start thinking about it in the interview. I think that becomes the most exciting interviews, where the questions become a little deeper, as I feel in the performances, you know, when you get characters which are explored a little in depth, one would not expect how they've been portrayed. I think that's when the conversations become interesting. So yeah, thank you very much for asking such interesting questions.
Thank you so much. So on that note, thank you so much for talking to us, Tushar, and I wish all the best for Ashram 2 and all your upcoming projects.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Take care. Stay safe. Bye-bye.
You too. Bye.